Hey everyone, welcome to the Cloudflare Fundamentals free course right here on the Webnestify channel. I'm Simon, and I'll be your guide through this journey. Whether you are a beginner or someone looking to sharpen your Cloudflare skills, this course is for you. We are going to cover everything you need to know to get the most out of Cloudflare, from account setup to optimizing and securing your sites. This course will be split into the many chapters as we go through each settings or each setup in your Cloudflare. And this course is designed to give you practical, easy to follow steps to maximize the potential of Cloudflare. We will start by setting up your account, ensuring your security with two-factor authentication, and configuring your site to take full advantage of what Cloudflare offers. By the end, you will be well equipped to secure and boost your website performance. And if you are ready to take things even further, I've got really great news. We are working on a premium Cloudflare masterclass where we will dive much deeper, covering advanced topics with real-world examples, custom roles, code snippets, and much more. To be first to know when the masterclass is released, make sure to sign up for the notifications at webnestify.email. And don't forget, after you sign up, check your inbox to confirm your email for double opt-in, so you don't miss out. And for now, let's jump into the fundamentals and start setting up your Cloudflare account. All right, so first what we need to do is to create our Cloudflare account. So when you go to cloudflare.com, you can see the sign up, you can click it, and now we can just start with the free. So we're gonna add our website, and now we need to get our email. So this one will be cloudflare.toots@webnestify.cloud. You will have to choose, of course, your own. And now we will need to generate strong and secure password. So for the password manager, I recommend Bitwarden, and for the password, I recommend the passphrase because it is more secure than default password. So let me add 13 words, generate something, verify that we are human, and you can check if you want to receive occasional emails, updates, etc. So let's click sign up. And now we will also need to save this in our password manager. All right, so for the domain, we just don't need to do any domain. We can just go straight to the Cloudflare platform. And before we do anything in the future with the Cloudflare, we need to make sure that our account is secured. So first, let's go to manage account and enable two-factor enforcement. But first, we need to enable it for our account ourselves. So let's go there. And we will need to verify our email. So let me verify it. That should do the trick. And now our account is verified, so we can skip this. We go back to manage account and we need to enable our two-factor authentication. So you click setup. You can add mobile app authentication, which you can click add. Now when you go to your Bitwarden, find your login details. So it was Cloudflare Toots. You go edit. And here you see the photo icon where it will automatically scan the QR code. So let's edit, click save, and you can copy this 2FA. And also you will need to copy the password for the account. Let's go next. And now we will need to enter our password again to see the recovery codes. Can go next. And now make sure you copy those. Go to your Bitwarden login for this account, click edit, and you can paste the notes there. And also you can download those files. And you can also upload them to this login, which is very, very great feature that Bitwarden provides. And when you see attachments, you can open it, you can choose a file, and we're gonna choose this Cloudflare recovery codes text file. You can click save, and that should be it. We can now close it. We can go next. And also what I recommend, if you're using Bitwarden or 1Password, which supports passkeys, you can also add the security key authentication. So you can click add. Again, enter your password. This was wrong password. Let me go there. And now, after a couple seconds, the Bitwarden will let you know on which passkey you want to save. So we want to save it for this account we created. And we can go click and save the passkey. And you can name it Bitwarden. And also, if you have a YubiKey or hardware key tokens, you can go and add another security key if you have those. All right, so now our account is fully secured. Let's go back to preferences. We want to switch to dark mode. The light mode I don't like too much, but this is completely up to you. And let's go back. Let's go to manage account. And you also want to all members you invite in the future to have two-factor on their accounts. And this is really important step, right? You don't want to add users that don't have two-factor authentication. And now let's up some basic things, which I like to set up on every each account that will be future-proofing. So let's go to configurations. Here you can change the Cloudflare account name. So it will be Cloudflare Tutorials. Here you can add the abuse contact. If potential abuse was found on your website, you can review the data processing addendum. And also, if you're gonna need to contact Cloudflare support, you can give them access to your to the Cloudflare support. You can edit until I revoke. So make sure if you're gonna contact support with something, you will need to add this permission. And last thing what I like to set up is the billing. So when you go to billable usage notifications, you can configure them. So if you're gonna use some premium features, you can add those notifications. As you can see, you can choose what you want to do, right? Which notifications you want to enable. So this is completely up to you, but I usually do billing. You're gonna set billing notifications. And here you can select which products if you have. And here you can specify the email. For example, if you have some sales department or something like that. So let's go back to manage accounts. Let's go to billing. And let's go to the payment. And this is what I like to set up on every account. For example, if you need to purchase domain or if you need to purchase Cloudflare Pro or something, you don't need to go there. So you can set it up straight after you set up your account. So let me quickly set up mine. All right, and as you can see, I have set up my billing information for my company. So you can edit either for your personal or for your business. And also nice thing is audit log for the accounts. So for example, if you're going to invite someone to your Cloudflare account, you can see the audit log and you can also enable the user level activity, which includes user login events and API tokens even. So we can enable it. And as you can see, we have all the things that we just changed since we created this account. So if you're going to debug something, for example, who removed the domain or what happens, who did it. Account audit log is way to look for every events that your invited users done in this Cloudflare account. And last thing that I want you to walk you through in the account settings is when we go to configurations and you will see the lists. The list means that means you can add all of your IP addresses that you want to whitelist at once for all future websites that you add to your Cloudflare account. And this is really powerful because you don't need to whitelist them manually in WAF settings that we will cover in the future tutorial when we will be covering the security. So you can learn more about the Cloudflare lists. For example, you can add IP address, hostname, or even ASN. So this is really pretty straightforward. So you can just do the CSV, or you can just do just plain text format, and it will be fine. All right. Next settings is the verified bots. So for example, if you are running your own bot that is not in the Cloudflare system that is verified, like Google bot, etc., here you can whitelist your own bot. And this is really powerful, for example, if you are running some Python scripts that are scraping something from a website, some data, etc. So here you can add your bots to your Cloudflare account. And I think that covers the basic account settings, because this is the first step when you create or start using Cloudflare. We need to make sure that our account is secured. We're using strong password, we're using multi-factor authentications, and we have all the things that we will need in the future ready beforehand. So let's go briefly how you can easily create your own Cloudflare custom list. So for example, when you go to documentation, here you can see the CSV file format. So let's copy this. Let's go to your ChatGPT account and you can ask, can you please create me a Cloudflare list with following format, and I need those IP addresses. And now, for example, when you need to whitelist all quick.cloud IP addresses, you just go to quick.cloud/IPS, you copy them, you go back to ChatGPT, press enter, and now the ChatGPT will generate you the Cloudflare list. All right, but we don't need a code block, we need the CSV file. So please output in the CSV file, please. And now the ChatGPT should output you a CSV file that you can manage. All right, looks like we have up our list, so let's download it. And now let's open it so we can see. Let me open it, and as you can see, we have our IP address and description. In this case, the description we don't need. If you want, you can also tell ChatGPT to add description. All right, so let me close this Excel sheet. And also, if you have your own custom IP addresses from the servers or infrastructure that you want to whitelist, you can add those IP addresses to this list. So let's go back to the lists. And as you can see, for the free account, you have only access to one list and 10,000 IP addresses. So let's create this list. This will be my IP. And here you can select IP. Okay, so we need to put a dash or something like that. Nope. My IP. Come on. My list. Okay. So let's go create. And now we're gonna upload the CSV. And as you can see, it pulls all the IP addresses that we added to the CSV. And we just add those to the list. Let's remove this first one and we can add to the list. And also in the future, you can also add your IP addresses manually here if you need. So yeah, that's it for this custom IP lists. All right, that wraps up the first part of our Cloudflare Fundamentals course. Now that you've got your Cloudflare account set up and secured, you are well on your way to optimizing your website. Remember, this is just the beginning. In the next part, we will dive into the DNS and domains, where you will learn how to manage your domains and settings and configure your DNS records for faster, more secure browsing. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss any of it. And if you are looking for even more in-depth tutorials, don't forget to sign up at webnestify.email to get notified when our premium Cloudflare Masterclass is released. This masterclass will cover advanced techniques with hands-on examples, custom configurations, and powerful code snippets. Thank you for joining me today. I'm Simon, and I'll see you in the next part of the Cloudflare Fundamentals course. Until then, happy optimizing.